wanna be my lover, you gotta get.
Your favorite thing delivered right to your door means that you never have to stop doing your other favorite thing. Nailed it. Order McDelivery in the app.
I was a runner. I was up to running 3 miles a day every morning. When I was diagnosed with lung cancer, I was shocked because I'm not a smoker. Baylor, Scott, and White, the facility, the staff, everyone has been so amazing. I love, love the fact that I can breathe.
When I first heard that I had cancer, I was referred to Baylor Scott and White immediately. It was really important for me to be able to get my chemotherapy and everything here because I wanted to be close to my friends, my family. They were so confident and made me feel at ease and supported me. I felt like I was their only patient, and I knew they had several people that they were dealing with, but I was the most important person.
I had like a week of headaches. Throughout that week, I went to my local hospital. They referred me to Baylor Scott & White. They gave me an MRI. The tumor that was inside of my head was cancer. Baylor Scott & White has given me this new technology that helps decrease the growth rate of my cancer cells. The doctor I have right now, he's just amazing. It's a great feeling to know the guy who's taking care of me actually really cares about me.
Baylor Scott & White Health, changing cancer care for life.
Prosperity Bank offers free checking. Let's take a look. No monthly maintenance fee? Check. No individual check fees? Check. Free debit card? Check. Unlimited withdrawals? Check. Free online banking? Check. Easy access and friendly service? Check. Close to home? Check. Simply free checking from Prosperity Bank is simply free. I'm taking these checks to the bank. Prosperity is the big bank with your community's bank inside. Prosperity Bank, where you find real bankers, not just a bank.
And there you have it, McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich. From the makers of the world's most stolen fries. The juicy chicken sandwich from the place that offers extra napkins for a reason. The tender chicken sandwich from the creators of a sandwich phenomenon. So you won't just be biting into a chicken sandwich, you'll be biting into McDonald's new crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Sometimes managing your health and keeping track of all the details can feel a little overwhelming. But UT Health East Texas Virtual Care makes it easy to stay connected with your health care. You can message your doctor, see test results, pay your bills on time, and even request on-demand video visits to be seen right away from the comfort of your own home. All through your smartphone, tablet, or computer, from virtually anywhere. Less stress, more living. When joints begin to fail, it's more than an inconvenience. The relentless grinding pain slows you down and can even stop you from doing the things you enjoy in life. At UT Health East Texas, our skilled orthopedic and sports medicine experts are using advanced joint technologies to get you back to being you sooner with a less painful recovery. We're doing more than restoring joints. We're restoring lives.
From a work perspective, what am I most thankful for? I'm thankful for working with a great team. I'm thankful for working for a company that's faith-based, and I'm truly thankful to be able to take time to pray with my patients if they need it.
Having a good team to work with and a great, all my supplies are there. I got equipment if I need it, and help at a phone call away if I need that as well.
I've never had a time where I didn't feel like that I couldn't get what I needed to do my job.
We work together as a team here at Baylor, and I really appreciate that.
I'm thankful that I have the ability to work, the physical ability, the mental ability.
I think every day that I walk into the pharmacy, everybody greets me as soon as I walk in the door. And it's a small gesture, but it goes a long way and it starts your day off right.
I do feel like I'm fulfilling my calling, even if it's, you know, the last job that I have. I'm thankful for God leading me here to work. I feel like I am growing into a much better nurse and I've been a nurse for a long time.
When I go home at the end of each shift, whether I had a bad day or a good day, I'm ready to come back to work the next morning. And I know a lot of nurses, unfortunately, don't get to feel that way about their job, but this is how we feel here, and it's not just me, it's everybody around me.
My team, they welcome me and respect me, my differences, my culture, and I don't feel isolated when I'm with them. They welcome my ideas, you know, they're always there for me.
We see people, a lot of brokenness, you know, physical, emotional, come through rehab, but just walking beside them in this and being able to help them get better, to see the outcomes of it, it's really rewarding.
I mean, I'm so grateful for Baylor, really. I love it here. Baylor's a very good place to work for. It's different.
I've worked at other larger hospitals and I would never go anywhere else.
I'm thankful for what I do. I'm thankful for the patients that we take care of. I'm thankful for my calling, my ministry. You know, is helping those who can't help themselves, being there for them. So I'm thankful for all that I can do for someone else who can't do for themselves.
Quality, affordable education is not out of reach. In fact,
it's closer and more convenient than you might think.
Trinity Valley Community College, with locations in Athens, Palestine, Terrell, and Kaufman, offers day and evening courses, online courses, and provides dual credit classes for high school students.
TVCC is also home to several national championship sports programs.
Your team leaves everything on the field. They play with heart and with their mind. But being smart starts long before the kickoff. With the latest technology, sports medicine advancements, expert physicians, we can keep your team healthy and protect joints and growing bones for this big moment and their future on any field. Physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine and Joint Hospital.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC. It makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
You from Historic Cardinal Gymnasium here on a Tuesday night. It is going to be a different night here at Cardinal Gym as we've got volleyball in the making, and we are pleased to have one of the best in the business right here to our left, Coach Aaliyah Hayes. I'm going to let you explain what is going on tonight.
First, it's great to be here, and you know, what we have going on in the gym is this is actually our second annual Volleyball Showdown.
Okay.
For Women's History Month, Audrey Hawkins, our Director of Student Life, she is wanting to get something together for students, staff, and everybody to support women and celebrate women during the month of March. So a couple years ago, she brainstormed and was like, let's do volleyball. And so it started off something small, and then we were able to grow it, and we did it the first year in 2022. And so it was such a success. We had a great turnout. It was students for staff, and that is actually what we're doing again tonight. So I got back with her this year, and I was like, hey, what are your thoughts for doing a volleyball showdown? And so here we are. Volleyball Showdown. We have students versus staff, and so staff includes faculty and staff in all capacities.
Now, if numbers have anything to do with it, the staff has a huge advantage There's like 74 of them. No, I don't know how many. We'll get to that.
Right.
But are you going to be like, are they going to try and do a few $100 handshakes to get you out there? I see them like waving over here trying to get your attention.
Well, you know, like always, there's things that they have questions to ask me.
Yeah, good evening.
So we're about to get to hear from Audrey Welcome Hawkins, the director of student life here at Trinity Valley. Let's tune in and see if they've got
Women's
her tonight.
Women's History Month Volleyball Showdown. My name is Audrey Hawkins, affectionately known as Mama A. I am the director of student life here on the Athens campus. Tonight we have the Women of the Valley, the TVCC faculty and staff versus the Women of the Valley TVCC students. Let me give you a brief history of this event. Year before last, we hosted this event for the first time. I thought it was just great. We wanted our office, the Office of Student Life, to rest on our laurels and never do this again. And then Coach Aaliyah Hayes, the Lady Cards volleyball coach, came to me and said, we want to do this again. So thank you, Coach Hayes. The theme for the 2024 Women's History Month is Women Who Advocate for Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion. As you see, our faculty and staff are clad in purple shirts, and our students are clad in green shirts. Women's History Month colors are purple, green, and white. Purple represents dignity and loyalty and determination of women who have fought for their rights throughout history. Green represents hope, growth, and new beginnings, and it symbolizes opportunities women have gained through their hard work and perseverance. White represents purity, innocence, and clarity relative to women's intentions, their messages, and their commitments. As we celebrate Women's History Month, let us continue to work towards a future that is more equal and inclusive. And now, I want to make an announcement. For those of you who came in, if you did not get a ticket, there are tickets available for you to get popcorn and a drink. We also will be giving a door prize prior to each set. And so now I want to just thank the administration. I see Dr. Parnell here and Mrs. Parnell. I would like to thank Coach Hayes, her assistant coach, her graduate assistant, and her Lady Cards team, who will all be coaching both of these teams tonight. Before I turn it over to our announcer extraordinaire, Stephanie Gade, I want to also thank my office, which is just an office of two people, me and Amber Howard. I want to thank her son, who is volunteering, Trace. I want to thank at the door also Mama M, who's Cardinal Hall housing manager. I have two work-study students, Montasia and Anita. Thank everybody who made this possible. And before we introduce the teams, we are going to pull a ticket. Get your tickets out.
Ticket time.
And the number is 786-6472. Okay, somebody must have gotten close. All right, I'm going to do another one.
Wait, can you say it one more time?
Okay, say it one more time. 786-6472.
You got a winner.
Oh, you got come a winner. On, bring me a ticket.
Little one, yes, sir.
And this is the daughter of Jessica from Palestine. Okay, somebody needs to come and help her because this bag is really heavy. And y'all might want to carry it from the bottom. I also failed to say one other thing. This one is historic in that this year, we have students from the Palestine and Terrell campus, and we have faculty and staff from Palestine. So we're just so excited. And now I'm going to turn it over to Stephanie.
Good evening, everybody. Let's meet the faculty and staff team from Athens campus, Amanda Beltran. From Athens, Teresa Boyd. Athens faculty, Jenny Cooper. Athens staff, Courtney Curran. Athens faculty, Dana Curry. Palestine faculty, Deanna Fry. Athens staff, Fabiola Fuentes. Athens staff, Sean George. Athens staff, Lacey German. Athens staff, Stephanie Golem. Athens staff, Candy Jones. Athens staff, Daniela Martinez. Palestine staff, Jenna McClelland. Palestine staff, Sherry Miles. Athens staff, Delana Newman. Athens staff, Stacy Palacios. Athens staff, Kendall Rice. Athens staff, Courtney St. Clair. Athens staff, Courtney Walker. Athens staff, Christine Warden. Athens staff, Caroline Whitaker. And Athens staff, Chelsea Young. The faculty and staff team, they are coached by Brittany Engelbrecht, as well as Nevaeh, Zarana, Sarah, and Andrea. Give it up for the Athens and Palestine faculty and staff team. And they are taking on the student team. Introducing the student team from the Terrell campus. Student Linda Sue Buchanan. From the Palestine campus, Alicia Hughes. From the Palestine campus, Jessica Jogi. From the Palestine campus, Caroline Skaggs. From the Athens campus, Meadow White. Also from the Athens campus, Naomi Cueva. Athens campus, Genesis Foreman. And from the Athens campus, Gretel Martinez. The student team is coached by Lauren Casey and assisted by Germany, Hade, Bia, and Jada. Our up referee for the evening is Hennessys. Our down referee is Ori. Our line judges are Sophie and Emma. And give it up for our scorekeeper, Cammy.
I have one more announcement to make. I forgot to thank a group of individuals who are here streaming this tonight. If you didn't know it, people can go to the website and see this. I am so excited. Give a round of applause to our IT department who's here tonight. Thank you.
We really do have the best IT department in the region. Thank you, guys.
they're learning.
Okay.
So the students were able to engage a little bit, mm-hmm. but this is one of the things that makes our sport different. We do sportsmanship
early, and then we finish off the game with the handshakes as well.
So they were called to action there with the handshake.
Exactly.
It was very, very well done.
Exactly.
But
like you said, there's a lot more staff in that line, huh?
Are you guys ready to have some fun?
Definitely loaded up with the staff. That's kind of a cool little, I think, nod to you and this event, because there was like, yeah, let's be a part of this. This is fun. So we're glad to be here. It's the Cardinal Sports Network covering staff versus students volleyball tonight. So if you're just tuning in, Coach Aaliyah Hayes is with us, and we're going to kind of pick your brain a little bit along the way and kind of get a behind-the-scenes look at what's happening with Trinity Valley Volleyball.
Perfect.
So talk to us a little bit about How'd you decide to become a coach? What's the genesis behind?
You know, that's a great question. I initially started off always wanting to work with kids.
Okay.
I love the little ones, and early childhood is where my education path was going.
Okay.
But with that, you know, education, and then it turned into kind of psychology, just by nature of where I started school and playing out at Texas Tech. And then transferring to Columbia College, I had to make a decision on my career path and my degree.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, psychology with education, it was a great fit because, coaching is teaching.
Sure.
And working with people. And I just got the opportunity after I finished playing. It took me longer to graduate due to transferring. And so I spent my extra year as a student assistant with the volleyball team.
Found out that was a good fit?
Oh, it was a great fit. And and the coach that I played for and then worked with, she's a Hall of Famer.
Wow.
And so it just,
if you're going to get bit by the bug, it might as well be by the best.
Well, exactly. And, you know, I did start off as, I mean, I am a coach's kid. So
okay.
I'm a coach's teacher's kid. So that concept is...
It's kind of in you.
It is. It is. I grew up in this kind of facility.
Love it.
I grew up in the gym. I was that child that was rolled around in the ball cart, you know.
So I was going to say that does make the perfect little stroller kind of setup.
It does, especially the one here on the side, so where the students are starting off serve.
Yeah. So let's see how they approach. Wow. Might be a quick game.
Well, and we talk about it a lot, but serving is a key element in the game. And so this will, once they get warm and the jitters get out, you know, a little bit of back and forth will help.
I was going to say, there's a lot of, you know, people have to kind of step out of their comfort zone, because it's one thing to know the game, to watch the game, love the Lady Cards and how y'all do it, but to kind of put on that purple or green shirt and come out here and, you know, that's a real nod to this event. So congratulations on that.
Well, and I know she gives me, you know, she is too kind with the credit, but it is her office putting it on and the support. But we have a great support system here at the Valley in Athens.
And it is.
And they just really want to be able to do what we do, you know?
And
this is where we talk about volleyball as a lifelong sport. It truly is a sport that you can play at whatever age. Speed of game is different, possibly. And as you can see, students are kind of off to a good start here with that serve.
They are. And I think that they've tried to get into the staff in the Cardinal Sports Network and try to, you know, do a few $100 handshakes over there.
There you go.
Because
but at least the staff did get a return on that one.
It was up.
Yeah. And, you know, just it's progress.
So the staff has a long way to go here. The students are off to a pretty
rough start.
Yeah.
You know, the students are off to a good start.
So let's see how they approach things here. Speaking of approach, let's talk about your approach. It's kind of recruiting, but not recruiting season. I mean, you've got a lot going on these days. What's your approach to recruiting as a coach, and what are you looking for when you're trying to find not only, you know, a great athlete, but a good fit for the team?
You know, I think recruiting is one of the hardest things that we do here as coaches, for any coach at any level, because you're trying to find people and young people at that who are going to be a good fit for your team. And while, and look at that. Look at that. We got a return.
So close.
Man, we were so excited for that second contact.
Everybody in the stands.
That was a great pass, too.
I think that's Miss Curry.
She's one of our faculty, and she's great in a job. Couple departments and does great. But, yes, yeah, so.
she did a great job to get that pass over.
And then her team was over here cheering for her.
That's
that
what
one
you're
just,
looking for. It back to the question.
It is. And that's so body language. Yeah. We look a lot at communication and team and those concepts.
It's changed in 10 years, 20 years. I mean, with social media and that kind of thing. For the youngster that's out there right now that's thinking, I want to be a collegiate player. Talk about the importance of being smart with your social media.
It's extremely smart, and unfortunately, you don't have the ability to go back and delete.
Yeah.
It's so much like words. When we speak words, those words can't be taken back. They can't be unheard. Mm-hmm. And now with social media, you can put things out there, but you can remove them, but they're there. They're floating around. And then the beauty.
Look at this. We're back.
The beauty of the screenshot. Look at that. Come on. Come on. Almost.
Give him seven hits. Play through. Play on.
Fun stuff. That one might have been a little bit of a net violation, but that was effort.
If you were not having a headset on right now, would you not be out there going?
I was. If you notice, I was kind of engaging and talking with the officials. We aren't as fancy as some of the officials you see when we come in Cardinal Gym and they have the headsets. But we were trying to.
Yeah. Well, that was a nice serve.
Except for I thought the staff got that ball because the students were in the net.
I thought so.
But I misunderstood.
Hey, I was enthralled with your answer.
Social media, it is such an important question. Anytime we go out recruiting, and a lot of times they have recruiting conversations. Whoever's putting on the combine, camp, clinic, they want us to sit in front of the athletes and the parents.
Oh, gotcha.
And we talk about it, and it doesn't matter what division. All of us say the same things, that it's so important. Again, we are just getting so much closer.
So
that third
closer. They're getting
is
better.
It's improvement.
It's all about the process.
That's right.
So with the...
But same with that recruiting process, we do talk about that quite often. We want them to understand that social media... I don't think we've ever been so excited for a miss serve.
But that was a great rally.
Standing
ovation. Yeah, she rattled off 11.
That was nice. Great. That's a great, and we've played a lot in this gym. And since I've been here, I don't think any of the years I've been here, we've had an 11-1 start.
Let's talk about some of the things that you've seen through the years. I know it's hard to single out anyone, but there's got to be some monumental moments that just jump out at you through the years. Probably during the season. Wow, look, here we go again.
We've got a rally. I am listening because as a coach, we multitask.
Yeah, sure.
What a rally, and that is a great hustle on both ends. But we've got .2 on the scoreboard for staff.
Staff has got two.
Woo,
now.
Good job, staff.
They're on their way to the comeback.
I just heard
Coach Hayes coaching from the sideline. Don't give up, staff.
Don't give up.
Yeah, so if you were to... The first one that jumps out to me is
2019 in August. It was the first win for me as a head coach, but it was more importantly, it was the first win I got to have with that team, and that's my first team as a head coach.
Wow!
So no matter what, like that team is
always going to be
so special.
Sure.
And they came off of a 7th place finish at the national tournament the year before, and so getting to come back in here, and that was their first game in Cardinal Gym with the new bleachers.
This place got the makeover.
It did, because they had that whole season at Athens High School.
I do remember that.
You remember that?
Yes, that was.
And my first game as a head coach in front of the people that you're working for and working with. We beat NCTC in 4 sets, and I'll never, I remember very specifically different moments from that match. And so that was a monumental moment for me as a first-time head coach.
That is so cool. I know there's probably many more.
Yeah.
Feel free to, as you see some of the parallels tonight to some of the great
absolutely.
Teams you've had,
absolutely.
To jump in there with that serve reminded me of.
Yeah. No.
But have you had some moments where it was a tough night, but you what is the phrase? Grow through what you go through.
Yeah.
I mean, some moments where you just, you know, man, we were kind of in a funk and we found another gear, another level. And how did you coach through that?
Work through
those times?
Yeah.
That's got to be tough. It's got to be one of the hardest things, I would imagine, is because
it is.
You're dealing with, you know, 17, 18, 19-year-old students, 20-year-old, and life in general is just ups and downs.
Well, and I think so often we forget that these athletes are students.
Student athletes.
And so, you know,
look at that.
And one of the things that really we emphasize in our program is that student aspect. And so, like, I get that they have homework, but the expectation is that they do their homework. And so on top of having to travel, you know, our schedule that we set, the schedule I put together, is not an easy one. And those expectations are just high.
Sure.
And so I think we as a society forget that student athlete is very real.
Yeah. I think that, you know, when they know coming in that expectation, mm-hmm. it kind of helps prepare.
It does, because I start that early in the recruiting process. But it also starts in high school. And the kids, like, maybe they had a tough freshman year. Because, you know, again, anytime kids go through change or people go through change, it's hard.
Oh.
You know?
Yeah.
And so it makes it challenging to have those adverse situations and overcome them.
I know that I've talked to you before and heard your heart behind. You know, my teammates, we were very diverse
mm-hmm.
from all over the world.
Yep.
And so I imagine there's, you know, I get homesick 40 minutes away. From,
oh, yeah.
So being a long distance, does that make it tougher or is it?
It does, you know, a couple things that it can be harder whenever there is that distance because phone, but now with social media, it helps.
Yeah.
Now with the live stream, our Cardinal Sports Network is amazing, so they
uh-huh.
get to watch them. But that, you know, that hug or
yeah.
just being across the table from them is not
sharing
there.
Sharing a meal together.
But I think a lot of times that what helps is that we aren't all close from home, or like
yeah.
we are all
kind of in a
farther away,
spot.
So
yeah.
it's a lot harder for the majority of the roster to. They can't just go home one night and then leave their teammates
right.
back in the dorm.
Right, that's a good point.
And so, because the closest we have, I think, in this group is maybe 2.5-3 hours, so it's Houston area. But you know, even whenever in the fall we had an hour to an hour and a half,
okay.
but that's still long and it's still
yeah.
far enough that you don't just want to go
yeah,
home.
Yeah, it's
when
not
it's
like, hey, I'm going to go grab a
dinner even.
Dinner,
cause gas,
yeah.
Because they have to pay for gas, you know, so there's elements. But yes, the diversity, I think, helps in a lot of those ways with having those. Everyone's going through the same things, whether it's hard stuff at school, hard stuff in practice. Being homesick, they're still able to work through it because they're not alone.
Yeah, you're right.
If that makes sense.
It does, because like you said, I mean, in a way it brings, hey, we're all alone together.
Yeah, we're all in this together in that sense.
Yeah.
Not to take something from High School Musical, but, you know.
Yeah, you going to make me get misty-eyed here. 20-9 here in this first riveting
yeah.
match. They both loosened up. Everybody's having
did.
A lot of fun out here.
You know, and like we said, it's about that serve. And so right now, that serve is what set them apart. But once this, you know, staff got to have a few balls, they're doing a little bit better. We did attempt to practice last week, which is just hard because, as Audrey said, we have students and staff. That's a great serve.
That was a beast of a serve.
But students and staff from multiple campuses. So it is challenging to come together.
What words of encouragement did you have for the staff?
Well, I was just so thrilled that they came out. You know, because it's
y'all
long.
Here.
It's
head
there
on
we
swivel.
Go. It's long work days, you know, and then
yeah.
being an 8 p.m. start, you know, I was just glad and thankful that they
there's
were committed
a good crowd
to support
out here
this
tonight. I mean, there's a lot of folks
behind
that came.
Us. We have people in front of us. I mean, it's
there were people in the parking lot when I got here.
I know.
We
had practice, and then I needed to run home to make sure I had what I needed.
Uh-huh.
And when I came back, I was like, there are already
there are people here.
Yep.
already. So, again, if you're just tuned in to the Cardinal Sports Network, thank you for joining us. It is the staff versus students. It's the Volleyball Showdown.
Showdown, yes. I think that was the coined phrase back in 2022, and we just kept with it.
And it continues to be a very fun event here. We're glad to be a part of it. If you are not familiar with that voice, Coach Aaliyah Hayes she's directing traffic. Good job. From the here to the perch.
Yes.
You've got the signal in. So first round goes to the students. They get the W over the staff. I know it's hard to say, but they got it done. So let's talk a little. Oh, there's a winner.
Oh, yes.
A winner coming out. See who they've already given away a couple of great prizes, and they'll be continuing to do that.
We were talking before the game that some of us players were, or my players were like, Coach, do we get to win those?
I need to win that. Hey.
But, you know, Audrey does a great job. She's got some – she loves to give.
That's great.
So I have no doubt that these are some really good prizes.
Well, I think that I see a lot of familiar faces in the stands of people that I would see if you guys were out getting ready to go take on TJC or Navarro or, you know, and it just – lends itself to say this is a special, special place, isn't it?
It is. And, you know, the Valley, it's a support system. And the fun part is it's really in their blood. Like, it is in the community spirit. It's what we want to do, and it's what the people want to do and help with.
So when it comes next season, and it's August, and it's 3,000 degrees out, and y'all are, you know, everybody's getting ready for, oh, man, it's almost football and volleyball. It's that time of year. What is your, you mentioned psychology. How do you guys, how do y'all battle the Texas heat and then just getting ready fatigue-wise? What's it like getting ready for your upcoming season? Because it's a grind. Y'all play a tough schedule.
It is. You know, I learned from my coaches. So playing at Texas Tech, Big 12, everyone's good.
Guns up.
You know, you have no choice.
That's
you just
right.
The season starts and you start rolling. Whenever I transferred after my coach was no longer with the program, I went to a program that was top in the NAI. They just lost in the national championship. So going from, you know, another elite school to another top level school.
Right.
And we always play tough competition. Because if you want to prepare for postseason, you want to play the best.
The best.
And I took that to heart, and I understood that as a player. I watched her success. She's won 3 national championships. I mean, that speaks volumes, right?
I was going to say.
And I was able to win.
It's a lot of hardware.
Yeah. That's... So one of my other monumental moments as a coach, it was that early career, I was a graduate assistant, and we won a national championship.
Wow. Let me jump in there. That feeling, is that immeasurable? Can you put it into words?
I can't, because all of the time and effort we put in every day, every year, and we don't get the same reward, right?
Yeah.
When it happens, it's really hard to explain. And you just are in awe. You are so grateful and appreciative. And just like it's that wow moment. And for us, we did it in fashion. Like we won 3-0. So we really got to show our abilities. Those young ladies got to show their abilities. And of that team, some of them are still playing professionally.
That's amazing.
That's at the NAI level, where so many people forget that there's NCAA Division 1, 2, and 3. There's NAI. There's junior college. Like, there's so many levels out there. There are, you know.
So let me shift gears on you.
Yeah.
Because you're once an athlete, always an athlete.
Yeah.
You're sitting here, and I know I keep looking out of my peripheral, and I see him looking over like, I'd love to have her take that headset off and get out here and help us. But, like, are you ever at, like, a church picnic and somebody pulls a volleyball out and they're like, hey, come on out, play? you have to take it easy on them, or do those competitive juices start flowing? Like, you better get back.
Well, I think as a coach, so part of my career, being able to go from a student athlete to a student assistant, shifting into a graduate assistant, shifting into an assistant coach, I think that gradual transition allowed me to control that competitiveness.
Yeah. So you're not Kevin James from King of Queens. When he's playing against little kids and he's a 250-pound guy and he's running with these little kids. One of my favorite scenes ever. But as we get set to roll on here, if you're just tuning in, the staff are on the left. Staff versus the staff. So we've divided up staff versus staff here. Staff left,
yes.
Staff right.
Yes, and we did that because, like we talked about, there were so many staff. And at the beginning, we only had a few students. So we wanted to make sure that the staff had the true opportunity
to get to play.
Yeah,
their abilities. Because the head coach is sitting right here. They may have a year of eligibility left. Who knows?
Well, and then set three will go back to students versus staff again.
Okay.
Which will be another good event. And as you can see, this is a little bit more competitive.
Oh, it
We've
is.
We've got a little bit closer score. And but we still have
cheering on both sides.
Exactly. We still have people that might get subbed in, and it allows for opportunities for everyone to get that chance to be in.
You are in recruiting mode.
Some people ask, when is recruiting season? And the true answer is we don't stop. It really is all of the time. Because you never know when you're going to interact with someone that might have the right connection for you, but also might be the right fit. You just click. When we talk about what are those aspects in recruiting, I mean, temperament, personality are huge for me. And that goes back to my degrees in psychology and elementary education. How people interact is super important.
It is. Do you ever get, in the midst, you're knee-to-knee with a potential recruit, and, it's 5 minutes in, and you just go, man, they're not a fit. They're not. Or is it one of those things that, over time, it takes a little more time? Or have there been those moments where you're just like,
it's all of the above.
Yeah.
It really is. Because whenever we as coaches make, I don't want to say the wrong decision, but when we go about something, when we know and feel that it might not be right, it's not going to be good for both parties.
Right.
Because,
that's a good point.
It's their future.
Sure.
And it's their experiences, and you want what's best for them. And so when those moments come that you're like, this is a great kid, just not the right fit, it is. Sometimes it's refreshing to have those finalized answers.
Yeah.
But it goes the same. I might feel right about the kid we offer, but they go somewhere else. It doesn't mean that they hate us or don't like anything at the Valley. It's just it wasn't the right fit.
Sure. That makes total sense. Well, I would like to just kind of talk a little bit about some of the teams through the years. Mm-hmm. One thing that always jumps out, beside the talent and them, but y'all are a close-knit group. Mm-hmm. It's obvious that everyone out there is playing for each other and playing, and you're coaching for them, and they're all in it together.
Yeah.
Do you have any moments you can share with us where it's just like, mm-hmm. oh my goodness, yeah, let me tell you how tight this group is.
I mean, the two that stick out to me at first, the first one is in 2022, I wasn't sure where that ball might
well, it just came up behind it. You do got a good sense of that ball.
My head's on a swivel. Always have to be watching. No, my first one would be fall of 2022 season. And it was that moment when we're at the regional tournament and we're in set three and, we're closing in at 20 points. And it was just watching the team work so hard together for each other and the bench or the players, the ones who contributed and didn't step off the court versus the bench who is holding hands, banding together.
That's
cool. That was the first championship for this program, for the school. It was history.
Yeah.
You know?
I remember just kind of taking it all in. After the fact, even going back and just reading about, Benny and how he is so good writing up the line and takes you back there. So when you get a chance to, you probably have to wait till the end of the year to really go back and, or do you enjoy it year, game by game, or do you have to just kind of look back at the end and go,
well,
that was a special
team? I think
team.
It's important to enjoy it in the moment, too. It's hard as coaches. Yeah. I mean, there's so much that goes on in the day-to-day, and, you know, our job is to win, and I think people forget that, too. And you know, our
a lot of pressure. There's a lot of
our first job is to the kids, and so all of that conflicts. The reality is there's a lot of moving parts, and they sometimes butt heads with it, and sometimes it's players and players, sometimes it's coaches with players, you know, sometimes it's professors and players or dorm and coaches. I mean, know, like you put humans together and you're going to have that. So I have found over the years it is important to relish in those moments and enjoy the moment after a big win to just enjoy it and not process it too much. But it's really nice and sweet to reflect back and just look at all that we accomplished. All the girls had accomplished.
Have you ever thought about running for public office? Because, I mean, that was a brilliant answer.
It's funny. I've had plenty of people that say that I would do well in politics, but the reality is people don't want the truth. And so,
I was going to say.
It would be really hard.
I would probably.
And I don't play that game. So the game that there is in politics, I just can't play it.
I don't blame you one bit.
You can ask my players. They know me pretty well.
Let's get a few more. I'm just teasing with you.
But they're just as honest. So they're gonna be straightforward with you as well.
Speaking of players, I noticed before the game, they were over coming asking you questions like, so the handshake and what you were talking about. What are some of the do any of them do any imitations of you? Do they like to?
Oh yes.
I've got it down.
I didn't realize. I mean, I know. So, I'm a very habitual person. I'm a very consistent person. If you ask the girls if I like the word consistent, they will all. I think without hesitation, it'll be a dominant yes.
Yeah.
So consistency is big for me. So when it comes to my behaviors, it's consistent.
So they see it. They see it. They know it.
They know it. And they don't get surprised by, oh, man, I did this. This is the reaction I'm going to get, you know? And so by the time they leave, they usually have some down. But the unique thing for me with this staff is, and all of the staff I've worked with has either played for me or played with me.
Oh, wow, that's cool. So they really know
They
you.
Do. So
that's great.
So Coach Lauren over here was doing some really spot-on imitations. But I learned this season, Hade has some really good imitations of me.
Did not know.
I didn't either. And they were like on point. So
if we did a split screen of you and then Hade.
Yeah, and if you throw Coach Lauren in there too.
Oh, we might need a
think
third
we might have to work on that.
That could be pretty funny. Well, I'm getting to learn all kind of things. If you're just joining us, this is the voice of Coach Aaliyah Hayes, and she's been instrumental.
Woo!
That was great. We do have a match going.
Look at that. That was Miss Curry.
17-16. Steph on the right, Steph on the left.
And this
a lot of noise being talked. They have to separate them. That net may not be enough separation.
And this is where the net is. Okay. did Henderson just call the net?
I think so. She's like.
So you aren't allowed to touch. So the net is there to separate.
Oh, gotcha.
But it's also there for protection. And so that's, again, where we talked about early, like sportsmanship is something that kind of separates volleyball in the sense that we wish good luck and then we say good game.
Yeah.
And it's very normal. It's because it's a non-contact sport.
Yeah.
You know, you talk about football, you talk about soccer, you talk about basketball. Those are contact sports.
Right.
You actually have body-on-body contact.
Yeah.
So there's a little different aggression that happens naturally, right?
I have not thought about it that way.
There's a reason I don't play basketball. It did not bring out the good, positive Aaliyah.
I can't. It's all positive. It's all positive.
Well, yeah.
You're gonna have to go something to trick me into thinking there's a negative.
But let me ask. You can't. You can't interact. You can have words, but there's no physical contact.
So when we see the the pass, the set, the coming over the top, and it's like, I don't know, a laser beam.
Yep.
How fast is that ball going?
You know, that's actually a really good question.
I mean, it's humming.
At least for us, that is not a it's not a stat, but it's not a measurable. Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Look at that. Lucky she got that back. Woo-hoo.
And then a little wrist shake there afterwards.
I'm with you. It's not something that we measure for us, like in the recruiting process. Now, I will tell you, there. Oh, look at the hustle. She hustled.
She was almost there.
The recruiting process at that next level, they do like to know the speed of the serve.
Roughly, do you tell us?
I don't want to put you on the spot.
I should have asked you.
That's okay. Honestly, I'm a volleyball coach. I should know the answer. So
I just know it's going pretty fast.
I want to say it's like 40 miles an hour. But in between, I can ask. One of the other coaches actually might know.
They keep more up to that.
Yeah, and that stuff.
Talk to me X's and O's. Because sometimes, like, I'm watching and they're, you know, they're doing.
Yeah, so just like football, basketball, soccer, we have plays as well.
Okay. So when they're holding up three or two behind them like that.
It could mean a couple different things. Okay. It could be the play call. Uh-huh. So when we attack. So in practice, we have a different net because that net has colors. So it helps with our placement.
Okay.
And so with volleyball, we have, you know, you've noticed you have the three positions across the
net.
Yes. And each position has a different attack that they have.
Gotcha.
And so each of those have a different hand signal.
Somebody's busted out and did the gritty.
Oh.
Look at that.
Wow.
That's impressive.
Did we get that on camera?
I don't know, but I saw it. I lost focus.
No, if I wasn't looking this way, I would have seen it too. Now this one will be students for staff.
Okay.
So it'll be students for staff.
So staff left won that for those of you scoring at home.
There you go.
So as you go back to that though, the plays, blah blah blah, all of that is.
Yeah, so whenever the student for the hands, just like anything, there we call it numbers, hand signals. And it allows for quick communication because, as you know, the game, that whistle blows and things happen.
Gotcha.
And it's quick. So hand signals take away any verbal.
Okay.
Because it also, like, for example, when we play TJC,
it's loud in here.
Navarro, I mean, it's loud with the band
and all of
it.
Cheerleaders and the crowd.
And again, like I said, no excuses. So as coach, my expectation is we communicate.
We got to be on it.
You have to know what your responsibility is. So those numbers can mean different positions that you're attacking. It can also mean how many are front row, how many are back row.
Well, so you got six on the floor at all times. Mm-hmm. You got your three, can you like sit there at night and just be like,
yes,
you know what, I've got the next monumental
my brain in that sense does not there. I have those moments where I fall asleep, but then as I'm getting closer to waking up, that's whenever I just have different thoughts that come to mind.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, we're gonna step away and take a quick break. It is the Cardinal Showdown, the Volleyball Showdown going on here at Historic Cardinal Gym. We'll step away and come back with the third set after this on the Cardinal Sports Network.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC, it makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
Your team leaves everything on the field. They play with heart and with their mind. But being smart starts long before the kickoff. With the latest technology, sports medicine advancements, expert physicians, we can keep your team healthy and protect joints and growing bones for this big moment and their future on any field. Physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Hospital.
No one ever said you need to be sick to get better. That's why at Baylor Scott & White, we're innovating how people get well and stay that way. where prevention might just be the prescription.
Way to work.
Teaching is on the treatment plan.
That's what I'll do.
And everyone is always on the same team. Yours. Baylor Scott & White Health, changing healthcare for the better.
Sometimes managing your health and keeping track of all the details can feel a little overwhelming. But UT Health East Texas Virtual Care makes it easy to stay connected with your health care. You can message your doctor, see test results, pay your bills on time, and even request on-demand video visits to be seen right away from the comfort of your own home. All through your smartphone, tablet, or computer, from virtually anywhere. Less stress, more living.
Welcome back, Trinity Valley athletes. Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Sports Medicine is here to keep you going at full force. Our commitment to helping athletes perform at their best on and off the field is our core strength. Whether it's orthopedics, performance, or wellness, physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Hospital is your choice for better health in East Texas. Just like every hard-driving Cardinal, we're focused on excellence every day.
The Volleyball Showdown at Trinity Valley. I'm Tim Howard. Glad to have you joining us tonight. We've got Coach
Prosperity
Aaliyah
Bank
Hayes.
Offers.
And Coach, let's talk about some of your compadres here at the Valley.
Yeah.
Lot of things going this time of year, right? I mean, the Lady Cardinals, congratulations to Coach Precious Ivy. They get a win today, big win over Monroe College. I was a little nervous for a while. They were down 11 at the half.
Well, and you know, it's tough. Like, it's one thing to go to the national tournament and play new competition, and because there's no place like the Valley whenever we get to have our home matches here.
It's loud.
You know, there's a reason we all try to travel, because we don't get to have playoff games here. Nobody would love to. No one wants to have them. But then on top of it, that's a great win for them just to get that first one out of their way.
Yeah.
Because they had to, you know, getting to Casper, Wyoming is not easy.
That's got to be a long.
Yeah. So that's a great win. That's a good.
So congrats, Star. What is it like? What separates the Valley? What is different?
The people.
Expand on that a little bit.
I mean, you know, it's a small town community. We're in small East Texas, so it's not the glamour.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not that we have brand new of anything. You know, it's the people. The people make it. They want us to succeed. They support us. And I would. That
I think
goes,
tonight's kind of a great
that,
example
I mean,
of
that
it.
That is.
Isn't it? I mean,
absolutely.
They're out here on a Tuesday night.
Look at
March.
It. Yeah, we have an event like this, and you have staff and students. You have your Cardinal Sports Network. You have a stand full of people.
Yeah.
But then whenever we have events like our showcase, the showdown or showcase, I can't remember what it's called, whenever we send off cheer and cardettes, the gym's full with that.
You know,
they are always cheering for us, and now, you know, we get to be an opportunity to share them.
We go to
regional tournament at Tyler for basketball, men and women's, and we have a packed house.
It's full house.
We went down to Lee College in Baytown, and we had the home favorite fans, and that's a three plus hour drive, and that just goes to show you the community and our host families and the friends of the Cardinals, and you know, all of the people, Dr. Morrison as a president, our AD, our VP, you know, so
it's really special place.
We just have people that support. And they like to be a part of it, too. And I think that's one of the things that makes us unique is we have a lot of program directors or coaches who want that integration, you know.
That kind of sums it up. I mean, it is the people.
It's the people.
And as a
I thought we were going to have an overpass kill.
I thought so. Yeah.
That's a great short serve, and I don't know if it's intentional to go that short, but those are tough. So you were talking X's and O's. This kind of serve that barely crosses that net can be challenging.
What is the toughest serve to defend? Is it that drop ball?
What do you call that, first of all? It depends, because a lot of you non-volleyball, you know, brains.
She's looking at me.
So when the ball is moving kind of like a curve ball in baseball and softball, that ball at speed is really challenging to pass.
Because it's so hard to
negotiate. Because of that movement, exactly. Because sometimes it'll go up, and then, like you said, it'll drop.
How do you prepare for that? Is there a technique that y'all can, you know?
We actually work on multiple techniques because I am a coach that thinks there is more than one way to pass a volleyball. Gotcha. And if you look at our team, every season we have different ways. Like each of the players goes at the ball a different way, but they're all successful with it.
Everybody's got their kind of style.
And that's where the athleticism plays in part. But
we got a volley going, coach.
Look at this rally. And it's,
it's my bad.
A perfect example. She knew us out, but she was so, like, we get so focused on the rally and we get excited that we go after these balls that we know we're not supposed to.
I should let this one go. Yeah. I've seen that
same reaction at some of my players before. And I'm sure as a player, I did the same thing.
There's probably a few out there.
I've done this. Yeah.
This seems a little, I resemble this remark here.
Yeah.
So what are you looking forward to most about next year's team? I mean, I know it's still a ways off, but talk about your students coming back and what you're looking to fill and how it's all going to gel. I know it's a long way, but it's not that long.
But it's not. Yeah, it is, but it isn't. And I think I'm just excited to get to see them compete and showcase what they can do because, you know, in 2022, I brought in a lot more. There were four returners.
Wow.
So we had a lot of newcomers. So that meant freshmen were having to take a strong role.
Right.
And that freshman group, I mean, they just blew.
Yeah,
what is that saying? They blew you out of the water. Like, is that you know what I mean?
Exactly.
And so, but then coming back as sophomores, they got to repeat.
Yeah.
So, like, now this freshman group, who are going to be sophomores, they want their back-to-back.
Absolutely.
That's how they've worded it. And so then the freshmen coming in want to be a part of that. They want their first. So I'm excited. So, and that's coming from them. That's not coming from me.
I love it.
Talk a little bit about that.
About your program that you've established now that, hey, man, this is kind of how we do it.
Well, what I love about it is, you know, eventually we always had big goals, but you have to start with that. You have to win more conference games than not, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And then if you really want it, then you've got to win regionals. And then at that point, now, I mean, the girls, they'll tell you, like, that's the expectation.
What was that experience like,
you know,
taking that group out there and just being able to experience that?
We were so close in 2021. We had the pieces. We had some unfortunate injuries.
Yeah.
And truly unique ones that I had never had. And to as far as one of the players had to have a root canal because of a ball, you know, like those things just.
I'm going to back up right now as you're talking about this because I'm all of a sudden getting a little nervous.
Yeah. So I got to see what could be here with that success and the run that we had. And then getting to bring in 2022 that the pieces and then just getting to see that success.
Building.
Come to build together.
That's
and
really cool.
And it, I mean, without the girls it's not possible, and they just continue to rise to the occasion in that, and it's been fun to help build that. You know, again, it goes to the people. We have faculty that make learning enjoyable, and mine are unique because I'm a coach that believes that we should be in person.
Yeah.
Because if not, they can just sit at home. Why are we, you know, giving them scholarships to sit in their dorm room? I just don't like that.
Wow.
And so we have faculty, and some of them are here on the court right now. They make learning more enjoyable.
That's a excellent point.
And then we get to play in these facilities that have support, and then we are supported and able to travel, which allows us to be seen for that next level.
Exactly.
And so all of those.
It's a win in every aspect.
It is. And just trying to tap into each of those things that help. And then you have, like, you see everybody around here with popcorn. You have Miss Rose and Jimmy who, you know, are
big
great.
Big old cookies the size of my hubcap.
They're at every home game. But then they're your friendly face in the morning at the calf for breakfast.
So cool.
And she knows all of her kids.
That's great.
You know, and so all of those things allow the program to continue to build.
I love how you take that, not just a hey, it's me and my three. It's the whole campus.
It
it's
is
a,
because
it's a whole environment.
You know, it takes it. But that's my philosophy. It's not, you don't need one good player, you need a team.
That's great stuff.
You know, you can have the best player in the world, but if they, in volleyball, you can't touch it more than one time in a row.
Can I shift gears and talk about the recruiting from not you recruiting them to the Valley, but helping recruit them to the next level? What is that like? I think we sometimes miss that. As a coach, what role do you guys play in that? How do y'all, are they just come knocking on your door, or do you say, hey, I got somebody? Is it a mixture of both?
It's a mixture of both. Whenever, you know, just like anything, it's all about networking.
Yeah.
And so, you know, when we have, they're trying to break a serve. Trying to break a serve right now.
Look,
and then you see the coaching staff trying to get back and forth at it. You gotta love it. But it is a combination, because if you have a player that just had a stellar night, and they really lit up your team. If a coach, a four-year college calls that coach and be like, hey, do you have anybody? And they might be like, no, but you might want to check with this.
Yeah.
So it's a
– She lit us up, and I'm just going to be honest. That was a young lady. It was hard.
And that's that sportsmanship I was talking about, too. It goes both ways, because volleyball is still not the elite of the elite in our country. Now, I will tell you, it's fast-growing. Obviously, 92,000 people in a football stadium to watch volleyball.
Isn't that awesome?
So we are growing, and I think that's – we just keep – just like Women's History Month, we keep fighting for each other.
Keep on, and
like we say, and we do. We compare ourselves. Like, what does basketball have? Because that's what we want.
So you were referencing the 92,000. Was that Nebraska?
It was Nebraska. So it was the state of Nebraska. So UNO, Nebraska-Omaha, played Nebraska, and then I want to say Nebraska-Kearney played – the other Division II, I cannot think of it off the top of my head.
But 92,000 people.
Yes, Wayne State maybe.
That's awesome. I remember when it happened.
We played outside. Yeah, right. So when you were talking earlier about like how do I prepare the team for preseason and the weather, that is one of the reasons I did choose an indoor. Look at that form, Candy. I did choose a climate-controlled facility.
Oh, gotcha.
So whenever the coaches softball, it's going to rain. I'm like, oh, really? They're like, did you not check the weather? No. I mean, unfortunately, selfishly, or by nature, I don't have to worry if it rains outside, if
That's
it's
right.
snowing,
you're
you know.
In, you're exactly
it
right.
It might get hot in here.
speaking of a couple of times, Cardinal Sports Network, we're carrying some softball this year.
Yes, and that's awesome.
1 o'clock start. Oh, it's pushed back to 3, maybe noon, or that's to awe factoring.
For them and their sport, the coaching staff, the players, they're used to that. They don't blink.
They don't.
We're like all of us. Remember the few games that we had an official show up late, or it was
Deal.
We're just because you're just
in your
waiting.
Rhythm and your routine. Right?
Yeah, you're waiting. There you go.
Look at that. Great stuff.
Oh,
she said, I'm going to take another crack at it. She did have the presence of mind to let a teammate try and get to it.
She did, but that was what a rally back and forth on that one.
Fun stuff. So I see you got your notepad. You're really taking some very intense notes. Are you trying to keep some of these people, you know, are they pounding on your door like, hey, you really got to look at my highlight reel?
You know, it's so funny. Whenever I am coaching, I've had so many people ask me, they're like, I just want to know what you write down in your notebook.
I'm just journaling.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. That's awesome.
Yeah.
If you're joining us here, we are in a real tight battle here. Students and staff going at it. And
again, the students are beating up on the staff a little bit.
They're taking it out on that midterm, right? I think. I don't know. Is that what's going on here? Oh, a little swat over the top there.
It seems to me that we might have a few more students that have
played a little bit.
Maybe
more,
you know,
sooner.
And I will tell you.
Yeah.
Because Trinity Valley offers great dual credit opportunities.
Yes, they do.
We have students that are of all ages.
So maybe some of these have been on the floor recently.
Right.
That's what I'm thinking. Well, that's going to do it for this one. Staff come up short, as you can see. But how about this? Are they going to walk through and shake
hands again? I was trying to see... because we do a three, we usually do 3-0. We'll see what the staff end up wanting to do.
I think they did
do the shaking of the hands and the good game, as you say.
So that could be it.
It could be.
And
I know we're going to get some pictures, and I don't know exactly. I know the students have obviously got to win. I don't know if they're going to do staff again. We'll see what Audrey decides. But
we shall see.
They've also been here since 7 p.m. They've been warming up.
They may have, you know, been a red ice at shoulder. I mean, I'm not even playing it. I'm icing a shoulder. I got to tell you, this has been a lot of fun for me. Just getting to hear your insight.
Yeah, I appreciate you letting me be on the Cardinals. You know, this is my first time wearing the headset here with you all.
We have been thoroughly enlightened, and I wish you nothing but the best.
Seriously, I
can't.
Well, I do think it's going to be a fun fall season. You know, we're anxious and excited to get back in the gym. So I
could see some of your players tonight as this was going on. They were just like, flexing a little bit, trying to get loose, and it won't be long. And we're going to blink, and it'll be that time.
Yeah.
Year, so.
Well, it always just comes up out of nowhere. It really does.
So when y'all hit the ground running, I mean, August comes along, you got camp basically.
Yes. So right now we're in the spring season. So this Thursday we get to go play Sam Houston State. And then we have a few more. We'll go out to Arlington Baptist. We'll go out and play Texas Women's and Texas A&M Commerce. And then we get to take a break for the summer until they return. August 1st is when we start.
Fantastic. It's going to be – you're getting – she's getting summoned here.
We're looking at that 3 or 4 sets. let me check real
quick. Yeah, sure. I'm going to stretch. And we're glad to have you along here as the staff come up short on that last one. But that is by no means a knock against the staff. Best staff around right here at Trinity Valley. As the students got a W. And we want to thank you for tuning in this evening here for the Cardinals Sports Network. We're going to take a quick timeout. We'll come back with more right after this as we... carry on with the Volleyball Showdown, TVCC Women Staff and Faculty versus TVCC Women Students here on the Cardinal Sports Network.
Would you look at that?
It's beautiful.
Wow.
That's our boy.
Get 2 breakfast sandwiches like a sausage McMuffin with egg or a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit for just $5.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC, it makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
Back, Cardinal Sports Network here on a Tuesday evening. Had a lot of fun here tonight. The staff coming up just a little bit short.
That's what they were telling me.
Against the students. Coach Aaliyah Hayes, thank you so much. Final thoughts from you. Anything you want to kind of – we got to crush the rumors here. I know you were recruiting me, but I have no eligibility left.
I loved this event, and I'm still blown away at how many people came out and watched.
Yeah, so much fun.
And getting to see everybody. You know, the staff just having that over, what was it, almost 30 students?
I think 30
staff and 30, faculty.
Yeah, I have a number.
I love that. And, that list is
crazy.
And so I'm just... It was so much fun to watch. It does. And just the joy whenever you see that joy of that first contact, and it's just like the light in the eyes. It's kind of like Christmas morning for
some. It is. The present is under the tree.
It was great. No, and I loved it. And, again, just getting to see everybody come out for it, I think just was something in there, you know.
Well, we'll look forward to
great words.
To more in the future.
Yes, and we're excited to get to be back here in the fall and can't wait.
Good luck against the Bearcats
coming up.
Thank you. Thank you all for joining us here this evening on the Cardinal Sports Network. For everyone who's been a part of this one, we do want to remind you that we have
the rodeo coming up just around the corner, not this weekend, but a week from Friday and Saturday out at the Henderson County Livestock Show, the Henderson County Regional Fair Park Complex. So thank you again for joining us. We'll look forward to that. Aaliyah Hayes, thank you so much, and we'll do it again. For everybody that's been a part of this one, I'm Tim Howard. Good night. Thanks for joining us on the Cardinals Sports Network.
Go Cards!